It's a shame that our country had to go through this. To be honest, it's a shame that your president has had to go through this before I even got elected.
Still dodging questions like their fields of wheat. Still got love for our lead in DUP. Still taking the blame. Still losing your game. Still somewhere between leave and remain.
Still looking up to fascists all across the world.
Still
facing amendments in the Commons, girl.
Still playing for time and still getting beat. And still can't handle the heat from the ERG.
Looking up to fascists all across the world.
Still
facing amendments in the Commons, girl.
Still playing for time and still getting beat. And still can't handle
Good evening and welcome back to CNT News. My name is Kami Sutra. And you join us this evening on Thursday, the 28th of March. Now, it's been a few weeks since our last broadcast. Do you know what? By the way, this means I'm going off script. It's nothing to do with Apple AirPods potentially causing cancer, although that is a concern. Apologies. I have been suffering with the flu. And not man flu, but real fucking flu. Anyway, I had the flu for a couple of weeks. And I came and I sat back here and I started doing the news. And to be honest with you, I realised that I needed to take a little break from the world of news. I mean, 18 months of news report after news report after news report, it really does kind of take its toll. But not to worry, because I've managed to get back on the wagon just before the shit has actually hit the fan. Over the past few months, we've brought to your attention the erosion of what many people consider their rights. Freedom of speech is a battle we lost. Whether it's Nazi pugs, or transsexuals in sport, or even movie references, freedom of speech is obviously a thing of the past. Freedom of thought, however, the battle continues. Whether it's what your kids are taught at school, or the censorship of Alex Jones and others, the elite continue in their pursuit of dictating exactly what you think. Add to this the weaponization of language and the considered narrative of inflammatory news stories designed to create divisions amongst us, then it's pretty clear to see that the free world is not so fucking free anymore. Now, these are just words, warnings which the majority of people either ignore or put down as conspiracy theories. But just look at the news in the world today. Not only is this a reality, but things are getting worse. We've moved into an era where people now have a strange sense of entitlement, where victimisation is now considered a currency. Just look at Jussie Smollett, allegedly guilty of a hate crime against himself.
How can you doubt that? Like, how do you not believe that? It's the truth.
What do you feel people need to hear the most?
I come really, really hard.
Remember that, with the noose and the Nigerian friends, remember? All in an attempt to cash in on victimisation. A And it's nonsense stories like that that lead on to bizarre calls for John Wayne Airport to be renamed, or a call for a black Mount Rushmore, or for kids under the age of 10 to be taught about LGBTQ practices. Kids under the age of 10. I'm 34. I don't even want to fucking know about that. Jeez. Now, add all of this together. The deterioration of free speech, the implementation of censorship, and the encouragement of victim culture. And where does that lead us? To incidents like the one in New Zealand just over a week ago. There's a video, but you're not allowed to see it. There's a manifesto, but you're not allowed to read it, with any serious discussions being flagged online. But why? Because we all know what fucking happened. It's a bit like when CNN told America that it was illegal to read WikiLeaks, but it was okay because Chris Dickface would read the Podesta emails for you. The guy that killed more than 50 in that mosque the other week, he used all of this stuff, all of this shit, he used it to manufacture a reaction in people that would lead to civil unrest. And that is what really fucking annoys me. Because he's getting exactly what he wanted. New Zealand are now imprisoning people for 14 years if they are caught in possession of a video of the incident, because they decide what you see and what you don't see. Australia have banned numerous social platforms, Gab, Dissenter, BitChute, because those platforms are to blame. Not Facebook, where the video was originally streamed. No, no, we can't be blaming Facebook now, can we? But even that is not enough to appease the victim culture out there. No. And besides, they've already decided who's to blame for this. Chelsea Clinton.
This right here is the result of a massacre stoked by people like you and the words that you put out into the world. And I want you to know that, and I want you to feel that deep inside. 49 people died because of the rhetoric that you put out there.
I'm so sorry.
Now, I'm hardly Chelsea Clinton's biggest fan, but in that incident, I actually felt for her. I mean, to have the angry mob approaching you. Of course, she pathetically apologised her way out of the situation, but with a baby on the way, you can kind of understand. By the way, the clicking, see the clicking thing? That's because some people find clapping offensive. It's got something from West Side Story. Yes, pushing the buttons of low IQ NPCs is exactly what the New Zealand gunman was playing up to. And unfortunately, that is what the elite have been playing up to all of their lives, using propaganda to divide us. Now, let's get back on script with some Brexit. Where do we begin with Brexit? The story changes by the hour. In fact, I'm actually sitting watching it right now because that's how much it changes. So what can I tell you? Well, it seems that the Brexit betrayal has begun because the UK is no longer leaving the EU on the 29th of March. It is now going to be the 12th of April or May the 22nd. Or it might not happen at all. So I hope that clears things up for you. Because it certainly didn't clear it up for the 500,000 people that took to the streets of London last weekend to protest against democracy. Yes, that march was full of people that lost the last referendum. And they want to reverse Brexit. And it's not just them. 5 million people signed a petition trying to cancel Brexit. And it's strange. It's almost like they've never heard of democracy. So when it comes to things like this, where confusion is awry, I often think it's easier when you go back to where it started. And for us, it began with David Cameron.
We are approaching one of the biggest decisions this country will face in our lifetimes, whether to remain in a reformed European Union or to leave. The choice goes to the heart of the kind of country we want to be.
The Brexit deal is agreed upon by this House, and certainly not to present an alternative between a referendum...
So we can't. Yes, David Cameron, back in 2016, making it clear to the British people what they were voting for. Seems pretty clear to me. But also, emphasising the weight of the vote. A once-in-a-lifetime opportunity. Until, of course, the era of victimisation sets in, where losers must be heard. Now, if last week was a crazy week in the world of Brexit, this week is fucking mental. Like I say, it changes by the hour. Rest assured, we will keep you updated to the best of our ability. But if I was to guess right now, I'd say it would probably be cancelled. However, it's not only Britain's Brexiteers that are cancelling a party this week. No. The Mueller report. What a fucking waste of time that was. The President of the United States, apparently, was not colluding with the President of Russia. Bit of guessed, eh? And the mainstream media are distraught.
One of the biggest questions tonight, why did Robert Mueller not come to a conclusion on obstruction himself? Why did he leave that to Rosenstein and Barr?
Whether we, the country, are ever fully told what Robert Mueller really figured out about Russia messing with our election to try to elect Donald Trump president and whether Trump and his campaign were in on that.
Now, most look like they've been slapped in the face. It's fucking hilarious, actually. However, they refuse to accept their own inaccuracies and instead claim that this is some elaborate conspiracy theory. Not that I would know about those, of course. Now, for a story like this, we're going to pass to Crystal Waters. I'm only fucking kidding. You think I'm mad? You know where we're going. Let's pass to Trent Stone.
Thanks, Cammy. Big news out of Washington this week when Robert Mueller wrapped up his 2-year investigation into Donald Trump and the election of 2016.
On my day of the interview, and I'm there with the president and his chief of staff, and in the middle of the whole thing, my cell phone goes off. I kid thee not.
And while the full report has yet to be released, there were a few interesting developments. Robert Mueller proved beyond a shadow of a doubt that NASA did land on the moon. The Earth is in fact oval. Climate change is real. And yes, the chicken came first. Perhaps the most shocking development out of the Mueller report so far was the release of the information that Tupac is indeed alive. He's living with Elvis, John F. Kennedy, Liberace, and Michael Jackson in Trump Tower. Hence, this investigation was merely not just about Russia, but about finding out who the hell would ever want to live in a building that Donald Trump does. Many Democrats were disappointed to learn that Mueller did not directly indict Donald Trump or his sons or daughter in the indictment in collusion with Russia. However, there is speculation now among the press that the real culprit behind the Trump administration, the one pulling all the strings, is in fact Hillary Clinton. That's right, we have it beyond a shadow of a doubt that Hillary Clinton is actually finally able to do the Republican conservative things that she really believes in with a Manchurian candidate of Donald Trump as president.
Probably a Manchurian candidate.
The tax cuts, Hillary. The Muslim ban, Hillary. The decision to serve French fries and fast food to the collegiate athletes, Hillary.
Well, I don't want to make any predictions about 2020, mainly because I'm saving those for my new book, What Will Happen? A Book of Predictions by Hillary Clinton and Paul the Psychic Octopus.
Now, Cammie, we may never really know what's in the Mueller report, but it's wonderful to speculate, which is the job of most journalists. Therefore, I hope that one day we'll actually learn perhaps the truth. But till then, speculate on. Trent Stone, CNT News.
Trent Stone reporting there. Now, before we head off to the break, our first two stories have both involved groups of people who have been left feeling outraged. How can this be? It's a combination of the era of victimization tied together with the mainstream media who are also keen to work up people to such a frenzy that they now feel that they've lost twice. So, join us after the break where we'll have some good news. Possibly. An IS leader has went missing. There is a group in California rebelling against Ocasio Cortez's New Green Deal. NASA have been speaking more bullshit. And we take a look at how difficult the life of a news reporter actually is. I'm going to catch up in my Brexit.
Actually lets you choose their body type. You can probably guess which ones we chose. Now I have a new workout partner and a new babe. Swipe up and find your perfect match.
Welcome back to CNT News. Now, a couple of updates for you from the first half of tonight's show. And it appears that free speech is under more threat than we originally thought, as the EU have now passed Articles 11 and 13. And if you don't know what those articles mean, then I recommend you Google them before you can't anymore. Also, Jussie Smollett has apparently had the charges against him dropped. I guess that's brown privilege for you, eh? Now, in the first half of the show, we kind of covered how terrible the world is becoming and how the bad guys are winning. But they're not having it all their own way. Since taking office, President Trump has unleashed Team America. Fuck yeah! In order to bomb ISIS over and over again. Now, with the help of this air support, Syrian forces have now taken back the final piece of land held by ISIS fighters. Tens of thousands of radical jihadists have now surrendered, with many more dead. And the so-called caliphate appears to be no more. Do you feel any safer? However, the struggle against radical Islamic extremism and those sympathetic to ISIS will probably be with us for some time yet. Now think back to Osama bin Laden. Do you remember how long it took to find him? Well, it appears that another ISIS leader has gone missing. Abu Bakr al-Baghdadi. And who better to find him than Sharon Breaknews?
Yes, that's right, Cammy. We have travelled for a few days through deserted Syrian bombed-out streets to come to this place at the border of Iraq. Now, our intelligence tells us that Islamic State leader Abu Bakr al-Baghdadi is hiding out in this derelict building behind us. Now, as you know, Cammy, the Islamic State leader has been missing in action, and as his forces are struggling against the US-backed coalition forces in a last-ditch effort to maintain their stronghold, it's all going down. But CNT has got exclusive footage now, and we are going to go inside and meet with this leader and talk to him and find out why he has been hiding for the last year. Let's go in and find out more. Bloody hell, Mark, this is bullshit. So, Cammy, it looks as if the Islamic State leader is not in here. So, Sharon Breaknews with nothing to report, over to you.
Sharon Breaknews reporting there. Now, before the break, we had mentioned to you the way political messaging is woven amongst biased news stories to create a particular narrative, to create divisions amongst us. And when it comes to Alexandria Ocasio-Cortez, this radical messaging reaches a whole new level. Cortez is stated as saying that Americans need to fall into line when it comes to her Green New Deal. She wants Americans to use aeroplanes less, if not ban them altogether. Just for you poor folk, of course, not for her, as she continues to build up her frequent flyer miles. The fight back against this absurdity is nothing, though. Nothing in comparison of her wish for Americans to eat less hamburgers and to ban farting cows. Farting cows. However, it appears a group of Californians have taken on her advice and moved their carnivorous attentions to another source of sorts. For more on this story, let's pass to Barnaby Frickleton.
Thank you, Cammy. Yeah, some very serious occurrences taking place here in Stockton, California. I'm in my backyard. The dogs are on high alert next door. Let me tell you about what happened at our local park.
Oh, give me a break. You ruined my new jacket. Kill him a lot.
Just so happens, Cammy, that while walking at the local park today, I found this. You know what that is as well as I do. And look at it. Dual-sided. Yes, Cammy. What to the creepy stuff going on here? What would look like just an average branch cut on both sides to the average eye stuck out to me very clearly as a backup vampire stake.
Hi.
Hi.
That's right, you can see it's not real large, Cammy, but it is two-sided, probably to be holstered on the ankle for a vampire hunter.
You're gonna wish you died.
It's very compact, Cammy, and as I mentioned before, dual-sided, so no matter how you grab it, you're ready to jab. So it appears that locally we've had a big battle between vampires and vampire hunters. So I'm on red alert. I've grabbed this thing just in case. I'm Barnaby Frickleton, CNT News.
Barnaby Frickleton reporting there. Now, no matter how bad things get in the world of news, whether it's murder, racism, political outrage, collusion. Yes, no matter the severity of the issue at hand, space news always seems to find its way into the headlines. Amazing, really, that regardless of the political climate, America and Russia seem to get on like a house on fire when it comes to boldly going. Add to that China landing on the dark side of the moon, and Japan apparently collecting material from a meteor. It seems that every other day we are fed more of this bullshit in amongst our usual propaganda. So when I hear that Elon Musk, SpaceX and NASA have successfully launched a rocket out of Earth's atmosphere, heralding the rebirth of American spaceflight, you can forgive me for calling bullshit. Because for once, it's not just me saying that. A group of scientists, so it must be true, now suggest that the Earth's atmosphere actually extends out beyond the moon. I shit you not. Science says so. Science says so. So when it comes to a story like this, who better to turn to than a reporter who spends her life with her head in the clouds? Yes, let's pass to Wendy Applebottom.
Thank you, Cammy. That's right. It has recently been discovered that the Earth's atmosphere extends way beyond the moon. Now, I tried to do some research on this and to see why we would even care, and to be honest, I did not understand a damn word.
They mapped out this geocorona around Earth in Earth's atmosphere, and they found out that the moon is basically sitting in the middle of it. So it's not like it's out on the edge. This is sitting in the middle, they say, basically.
What I want to know is, why does NASA, who spends about $17 gajillion a year of the U.S. money that we don't even have, to research things and bring us things like a pen that can write upside down? Or Velcro. Now, don't get me wrong, Velcro is quite useful, but to be honest, it would have eventually been developed by some farmer who got stuck with a briar, and they would have brought it to Shark Tank, and none of us would have had to pay for that.
I see it as a novelty product. I can't see you ever making money with this, so I'm out.
And I know there are people who will defend NASA until the day they die. But to be honest, the most interesting of those are the people that believe NASA needs to explore other planets so that we can find a new place to live on when this planet's gone. Yes, by all means, let's spend all our money looking for a new place instead of fixing the one we have and taking care of the people that live here now. I mean, really, do we need to find another flat planet to inhabit? Wendy Applebottom, back to you, Cammie.
Wendy Applebottom reporting there on more of NASA's bullshit. Coming in a week where cries of conspiracy are rife, it seems the majority of people are oblivious to some actual Russian collusion that's been with us since the 60s. Now, for our final story tonight, and as I touched on at the start of the show, being a newsman can be pretty fucking difficult. Some of the horrible, horrendous, harrowing news stories that you have to consume can really take its toll on you. And that is just the stories fed to us by the mainstream media. As well as dissecting everything that the fake news media throw at us, we still need to find time to do our own research, our own investigations, to bring our own news reports. And to try and juggle all of this, I think you'd have to be Superman. Which is why, week after week, I thank my lucky stars that we have a reporter in our midst that could live up to the term superhero. He also has trouble wearing his underwear properly. Yes, I've missed him. You've missed him. And we've got him out of his chamber of solitude. Yes, let's pass to Les Whitlock.
Hey everyone, it's Les Whitlock from CNT News in Washington, D.C. I'm here in my dining room in Silver Spring because it snowed. And this is the same dining room that we have small baby gates to keep my fat puggle dog out because he wandered in here and when he gets mad, he takes a piss on my carpet. So I thought that was important for me to tell you because I know that a lot of you are wondering, where has Les been? Why isn't he reporting? You know, why isn't he doing that Peabody type award reporting like the report with Mohammed in the cab? Well, folks, reporting can be quite challenging. And coming up with news stories each week that are more exciting and unique and better than the week before is not easy to do. So today I thought I would just talk about something very mundane. It happens to be a plate I have over here. Let's see if I can keep your interest. So we have what's called a plate rack. Does anyone have a plate rack in their homes? Well, a plate rack is where you take plates, some plates you eat off of. These happen to be plates that you just look at. I don't think they've been anyone's et off them for a long time. And this happens to be a, look at this beauty, look. It's a man, a male suitor and his wife. And you can only imagine what they're talking about. She looks upset. I can see by their body language that maybe they're in a relationship a long period of time. Where, you know, this is typically what happens when there's lack of communication between a husband and a wife. And it's depicted perfectly in this colonial era plate. This is the Spode collection. So just remember, folks, that sometimes in the news, we just need to talk about things that are in some ways boring because that's the majority of what life is about. it's boring things like your dog peeing on the floor or your little decorative plate that you have up that you never use with the two distraught lovers. So that's the report this week from me, Les Whitlock. Get in there, you stupid plate. It's me, Les Whitlock of CNT News, reporting from Silver Spring, Maryland, in my dining room with my plates. Thank you.
Forget the Man of Steel, our very own Man of Porcelain, Les Whitlock reporting there. And that is about all we have time for this week. A huge thank you to you, the viewer at home. A huge thank you to my comrades across the planet. We live in a world where people are obsessed about securing their rights. However, we would live in a better world if people thought of it less as their rights and considered it more their responsibilities. So join us next week when we will find out if Theresa May's Brexit is actually a Hotel California Brexit. But you can check out any time you like, but you can never leave. Don't have nightmares, and we'll see you next Tuesday. Man of Porcelain, come on, that's quite fucking good.
So take the photographs and still frames in your mind. Hanging on a shelf in good
Mike,
health and good time.
What the hell is that?
Tattoos and memories.
Sounds like a train's coming. Where the hell are we? We're supposed to be in the middle of nowhere.
I can absolutely guarantee to my right honourable friend that we will be leaving the European Union on the 29th of March 2019.
This government is committed to delivering exiting on the 29th of March. Could I just confirm we will be leaving on the 29th of March 2019? The people have the confidence of knowing the date on which we'll be leaving the European Union, which is the 29th of March 2019.
And if anybody is in any doubt, we are going to leave the European Union on the 29th of March 2019.
Liberty is a Nazi! Liberty is a Nazi!